That was Red Eyes and Tears by Black Rebel Motorcycle Club off their 2001 debut album, BRMC. I've always just really loved that album, like ever since the first time I heard it. You put it on and it's just like a super cool sound. That's just one of those things that I just describe as cool sounding. Like if cool was a genre, stuff like Black Rebel Motorcycle Club, at least their earlier stuff, would be it. Like, it just sounds like a bunch of, like, cool-ass dudes in black leather jackets, and that's what it is. It's cool. Like, Nick Cave is cool. Some stuff's just cool. At least it's my ideal of cool. I can't say that everybody thinks the same stuff is cool. Speaking of cool, we've got a cool matchup today for Butthole Surfers. One of the songs is from their 2001 album, Weird Revolution, and that's why we're listening to a song from 2001 today. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 111 of the Butthole Surfers Tournament. We're on match 5 of round 4, so just blasting through it. There's only 16 matches in round 4. This is going to be really short compared to what we've been doing. I mean, a 2-week round? Holy crap. Of course, as per usual for this round, we do have two songs that we've already heard going head-to-head, but we haven't heard them go against each other, so we're gonna do that today, and see which one of those two songs is better. Now, first up, I have a song that's been given, a lot of leeway, I think. I've got The Shame of Life, which is track 2 off of Weird Revolution, and, I'm just now realizing that I have a song that was co-written by Kid Rock in round 4 of my Butthole Surfers tournament. I gotta be on the same type of drugs these guys are on, right? Just weed. I don't know how this song made it this far. It's just super catchy, and it has, like, some memories for me, you know? But, it had a fairly easy trip through the first round. Well, actually, you know, it had a pretty easy trip so far. Like, the first round, it had a bye. And in the second round, it went up against Strangers Die Every Day, which I think was pretty easy to beat if you were a song, pretty much. Because I think that one was just more like some noise with, like, I want to say there was, like, some spoken word stuff going on that one. I might be wrong on that. And then it went up against Creep in the Cellar, which really, thinking about it now, maybe I should have picked Creep in the Cellar. I was really surprised by what Creep in the Cellar was. And there's really not much to the song, though. I think that's why I went with The Shame of Life, because it just feels more like a full song. Creep in the Cellar, before it lost to Shame of Life, went against Hey in the second round. And Hey went against Hey in the first round. And that's going up against Dum Dum off their 1984 debut, Psychic Powerless, Another Man's Sack. So we have two songs from both ends of their career going against each other today. Not technically their first release, but then again, Weird Revolution isn't their final release either. Weird Revolution came out before the compilation album, which had a bunch of 80s stuff mostly on it. And a little bit of 90s stuff. And an EP came out before Psychic Powerless and Other Man's Sack. But as far as like full length studio LPs, it's the first one against the last one. Dum Dum went up against Imbuya in round two from their abandoned album After the Astronaut. I didn't really like Imbuya. The only reason Imbuya made it to round three was because in round two it went against their live cover of Come Together, which was really short, and I don't like covers, and it was super short, bad quality. Imbuya pretty much had an easy track through there, and it had a bye in the first round. Dum Dum had a bye in the first round, just like Imbuya did, and that went up against Waiting for Jimmy to Kick in round two. I can't really remember what Waiting for Jimmy to Kick was, so I don't know how hard that was for it. Part of the problem with only listening to these songs one time sometimes is I've listened to now every single song Butthole Surfer's ever put out, but a good half of them I've only listened to once. Well, almost half of them, because some of them that I eliminated in the first and second round I had heard before. But there's a good portion of them I've only heard once, that one time in the tournament. So that makes it hard for me to decide if I fucked up on kicking out Waiting for Jimmy to Kick. But this is round four, and that lost in round three. We're going to listen to Dum Dum. So since we've heard these before, let's just go ahead and get right into it. First up, we have The Shame of Life.
I love the girls and the money and the shame of life. My shallow mind is just a sign of your game of life.
There were girls in the front and there were girls in the back, and there were girls petting squirrels, and there were squirrels smoking crack with an old Navy SEAL in the DEA and a loaded automatic just to blow me all away, with the dog drinking liquor from a hole in the sky and a picture of a picture. Just had a guy, he had a problem with his sister and a 3D cups and a brother with a shovel just to shake it off.
Yeah.
So the sign of a good song in one of these tournaments typically is one that through repeated listens when you're going through the tournament, you start to like it more and more. It stays stuck in your head for days after the fact. And one of the signs of a song that you may have wrongly picked is that you really just don't want to hear it every time. Getting tired of the shame of life three times in this tournament is enough. Unless Dum Dum sucks. Let's see how Dum Dum sounds. Shame of life is just boring. Here's Dum Dum. That's a really good one. definitely kind of a slower, chuggy pace, which I like, but it doesn't have, it's not boring at all. I don't know, Shame of Life just sounds boring. Like, there's no emotion to the chorus. I love the girls and the money and the... I don't know. I guess it's supposed to sound pretty vapid, too, though. Like, it sounds like it's kind of... mimicking the superstar lifestyle. I mean, obviously they had it briefly. Probably got burnt out on it pretty quickly. Dum Dum again, and I've talked about it before. I love how it's got the feedback in between the verses and ending the song, just like a trolled guitar feedback is gonna grate on so many people, but I love feedback. It's one of my favorite sounds in music. Just something sharp and atonal that goes against everything else that you're listening to. I enjoy that kind of dissonance, I guess. I'm gonna go with Dum Dum. Let's get the Shame of Life out of here already. Dum Dum's gonna move on into the next round, and I'm happy about that. I don't really see any reason to let the Shame of Life keep going unless I'm just looking for songs that would make it on the radio, and this absolutely would have back then. It gained a modicum of popularity. Never got as big as Pepper, but still a pretty popular song. But Dum Dum is way better. Dum Dum all the way. Got social media if you want to talk about it. We've got Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. We've even got a TikTok now, and you can check out the shortened versions of these videos. I shoot the videos and then I edit them down into this really as short as I can get it format. And then Cam takes that and edits it down even shorter. That's TikTok. If you don't have time to listen to the entire song, it's a good way to go, too, because he just doesn't play the entire song. He plays like a snippet. You can also vote on the Instagram story. I link the songs down below in the description, so you can check them out on your own if you'd like to. I'll also link that Black Rebel Motorcycle Club song. If you have not heard that band, I highly recommend at least the first two albums. Super cool. Super cool. I've got Venmo and a Cash App as well, so feel free to hit up those handles down below me here. Like this video if you like the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'd like to see you come in here all the time. All of us are hanging out together. And you guys are welcome too. Come on. Share it with your friends. They're welcome too. Everybody, come on down. Everybody, come on down. comment down below with which of these two great songs you would have chosen if it were you in the hot seat today. And that's all the Butthole Surfers I have for you today. I'm going to be back in a couple minutes with some Beatles content, though. So make sure you show up for that. All right, I'll see you later. Hope you have a great night, wonderful afternoon, and a fantastic morning. Bye. And that's it. And that song will be... And it's going up. I should just say what it is. Yeah, okay. Where is it? And that's going to get...